Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to solve a related rates problem. Find the rate of change of the distance between the origin and the moving point on the graph of y is equal to x squared plus 1 if dx dt, or the change in x over time, is equal to 2 centimeters per second. Let's begin by rewriting this equation. Here we have y is equal to x squared plus 1. We see that our degree of this equation is 2. This is a quadratic equation, so that means that we have a parabola. Because we have a positive sign in front of the x squared, we know the parabola opens in an upward direction. And since we're adding 1, we know it has a vertical shift of 1 unit. Let's go ahead and sketch in what this looks like. So this here's our y-axis, then our x-axis. This here is the 1 unit up. And now let's draw in our parabola. So let's have our parabola here where the vertex is going through the point there at 0, 1. We know that we have to find the distance between the origin. Well, the origin we know is at position 0, 0 and a moving point on the graph. And let's just go ahead and arbitrarily place that point here, but know that the point is actually traveling along this function. And we want to find this distance. So let's draw a straight line from the origin to the point on the function. And now let's drop in a vertical. And then let's draw in a horizontal. Notice that we've just created a right triangle. So we're going to relate equations for the right triangle to this particular problem. Let's just talk more about the sides here, or the legs. This leg here I'm going to call A, this leg B, and this leg C. If we look at what we're dealing with in particular for this question, we know the length from here to here tells us that the value for A has to be X, and the height, because this dot here is on the function, we know that height has to be X squared plus 1. And now what we're going to do is we're going to relate that back to the Pythagorean theorem. We know that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. So now let's make the substitutions. Right here, we're going to keep the c squared. We know that a is an x, so this here becomes x squared plus. We know that b is the quantity x squared plus 1, and that there also has to be squared. We want to find the change in this distance over time, so we need to take the implicit, we need to use implicit differentiation with respect to time on this entire equation. So here we're going to take the derivative of c to the second, where that there becomes 2c. And because we're taking the derivative with respect to time, this here becomes dc dt. So that's the factor that we add on. Next, let's take the derivative of x to the second, where that there becomes 2x. Again, because we're taking derivative with respect to time, I need to add in dx dt. Plus, when I come to this term, I have to use the chain rule. So the chain rule and the power rule. So I'm going to bring this 2 out forward. Going to rewrite everything in my parentheses, x squared plus 1, and I'm going to decrement this power of 2 by 1, so this is understood to be to the first power, and then I need to multiply by the derivative of the inside. Well, the derivative of x to the second is 2x, and if I add on the derivative of a constant, that would be plus 0. There's no need to write in the plus 0, but again, I took the derivative with respect to time, so I need to add on the factor dx dt. Now at this point, I need to do some simplification. Let's begin by, we're going to leave the left-hand side alone for a moment. Let's begin by working on this right-hand side. I see I have a dx dt as a factor, so I'm going to factor that out. So let's put dx dt here in the front. Then I'm left with a 2x plus, well, I have a 2 times a 2x to give me 4x. Then I multiply that by the x squared plus 1, and I close everything off here. Now at this point, let's bring down this 2c dc dt. As I continue, I can do some simplification inside here. So here I have dx dt times 2x plus, well, 4x times x squared gives me 4x to the third, and then 4x times 1 gives me a positive 4x. All right, let's scroll down a bit. Notice I've got like terms, so I can add these two together, 2x plus 4x to give me 6x. So let's rewrite dx dt. So now I have 6x plus 4x to the third. And again, this part here is coming down. And what I want to do is let's go ahead and divide by 2c on both sides, because I want this to just have a dc dt. So I'm going to divide the left hand side by 2c. So if I divide it by 2c, that cancels here. And on the right hand side, I need to place in that 2c. So here I have dc dt is equal to dx dt. If you look here, you see I can factor out a 2x. So let's do that. So here I'm going to place the 2x here on the outside. So now 2x goes into 6x three times, and 2x goes into 4x cubed, 2x squared. And then for my denominator here, I'm going to keep this 2c, and notice that these 2's here cancel, and I'm left with dx dt, and then I have times x times the quantity 3 plus 2x squared, and then all of this is over c. Alright, we don't know what c is, but if we take a moment and look back at what we had, we know that c squared is equal to a squared plus b squared, and we just said that a was x, and we said that b was the x squared plus 1 squared. So there we have the c squared. We want to know what c is, so we take the square root of both sides. So here we see that c is equal to the square root of x squared plus the quantity x squared plus 1 squared. And again, all I did here was I just made the substitution that we did earlier right here. I just solved for c because we needed that in the equation. All right, also we know that dx dt is 2, and that's what we have here, so I'm going to make that substitution as well. All right, so now when I scroll back down, I've got dc dt, and let's change this to another color so it stands out. We know that dx dt is 2, so this here is really 2c, whoops, not 2c, it's really 2 times x, and then we have the quantity here, 3 plus 2x squared, and then for our denominator c is this expression that we have here, which is the square root of x squared plus the quantity x squared plus 1 squared. So this here represents this here is the equation that represents the change in distance over time as the x value is changing at a rate of 2 centimeters per second. So as this is moving along the curve here, for us to figure out that distance at a moment in time, this here would be the expression that we would use. All right, that sums up this tutorial by ajspeller.com. And as always,